Baseball rules that almost no one understands.
That's a strikeout. There's a violation. Ron Culpa just rung up Manny Machado.
I'm just doing what the rules are said. I had 8 seconds to call a timeout. I called it at 8 seconds. He did not give it to me. And, now I got struggling out, hurt my team by coming out the game and getting tossed there. And, I feel like I didn't do anything wrong.
Okay, so you have the pitch clock rule. How does that work? Well, you have 30 seconds between batters. And then if you have runners on base, you have 20 seconds between pitches. And if there's no one on base, you have 15 seconds between pitches. The pitcher gets 2 disengagements or an opportunity to step off the rubber and reset for free. After those 2, penalty is a ball added to the count. Now, if the offense does something like ask for time, steal a base, something like that, then the pitcher gets their resets back. Now, the pitcher has until 0 to begin their delivery to pitch, whether it's from the stretch or the windup. Now, let's talk about the batter. The batter has to be alert, facing the pitcher, ready to swing by the time the pitch clock says 8 seconds. The batter gets 1 reset per at bat. However, they have to request that before the 8 second count. If the batter is not ready by the time the clock reads 8 seconds, or if they ask for time after the 8 seconds, penalty is a strike. It's added to the count. Now, these rules are exclusive to the pro level. College has a completely different set of rules concerning pitch clock. And the high school level that I work in doesn't have a pitch clock at all.